let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out. Let it rain. Let it rain.
Jesus, sweet Jesus, how wonderful you are. You are brighter than the morning stars. You are fairer, much fairer than the lily that grows by the rainside. You are precious, more precious than gold. Glorious God, beautiful King, excellent God, I bow before your throne. Eternal Rock of Ages, I want to say thank you to your name. I give you glory for this awesome moment. Thank you for what you're about to do this morning. King of glory, please accept our thanks in Jesus' name. My God and my Father, we're here in your presence to hear from you, O God of heaven. Today you will bless the speaker, you will bless the hearer in the name of Jesus. Bible says, in the city of Ephesus mightily grew the word of God and prevail. Therefore, my Father, my God, today let your word grow in this place and let your word prevail against every situation and circumstances that is not favorable to our lives. In the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you will make my mouth a pen of a steady writer, and that which and the purpose why you want to send forth your word, let your word be confirmed in the life of your people. In the name of Jesus, glory be to your name. In Jesus' mighty name, I have prayed. Amen. Good morning, viewers at home. It's my pleasure to come your way once again this morning. Today is the 25th of the month of July. The month is running to an end, and likewise the year is also running to an end. Of course, we know that whatever that has a beginning must also have an end. So we want to appreciate the name of the Lord for his mercy that kept us from the month of January up unto this day. Father, we give you all the praise. We give you all the glory for your protection and your favor that has seen us through up until now. So today we shall be looking at don't be an accomplice. Don't be an accomplice. That is the topic before us this morning, this faithful morning. And our memory verse shall be taken from the book of Romans chapter 1. Romans chapter 1, we shall read verse 32. It says, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them that do them. Let me read it again for emphasis sake. See, Romans chapter 1, verse 32. See, who knowing the judgment of God, that they which commit such things are worthy of death, not only do the same, but have pleasure in them, in them that do them. They have pleasure in those that are involved in evil, in wickedness. They may not be the one that actually, involved in the act, but If you delight in someone that is involved in wickedness, you are also an accomplice. May that never be our portion as the children of God, in the name of Jesus. So our Bible reading shall be taken from the book of Acts, chapter 1, chapter 5, Acts chapter 5, from verse 1 to 11. Acts chapter 5, from verse 1 to 11. Acts chapter 5, from verses 1 to 11. But a certain man named Ananias, with Sapphira his wife, sold a possession, and he kept back part of the proceed. His wife also being aware of it, and brought a certain part and lay it at the apostles' feet. The wife was aware of the total amount that the land was sold. And it was not impossible that this conspiracy was the brainchild of both of them. So, but Peter said, Ananias, why has Satan filled your heart to lie to the Holy Spirit and keep back part of the price of the land for yourself? Why it remained? Was it not your own? Why it remained? Was it not your own? And after it was sold, was it not in your own control? Why have you conceived this thing in your heart? You have not lied to men, but to God. Then Ananias, hearing these words, fell down and breathed his last. So great fear came upon all those who heard these things. And the young men arose and wrapped him up, carry him out and bury him. What a disaster. What a disaster. Now it was about 3 hours later when his wife came in, not knowing what had happened. And Peter answered her, tell me whether you sold the land for such. She said, yes, for so much. Wow. Then Peter said to her, how is it that you have agreed together to test the spirit of the law? To test the spirit of the law. Not to test Peter. Not to test other apostles that were there. But to test the spirit of the law. Peter revealed to us what actually happened, what they were trying to do. He said, look, the feet of those who have buried your husband are at the door, and they will carry you out. Then immediately she fell down at his feet and breathed her last. And the young men came in and found her dead, and carrying her out, buried her by her husband. So great fear came upon all the church and upon all who heard this thing. Father, bless your word in our heart, in the name of Jesus. And as we expand further through this teaching, Holy Spirit, rule in our heart. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, I have prayed. Amen. So that is the test for our teaching today. The topic says, don't be an accomplice. Don't be. It sounds like an advice. Amen. Don't be an accomplice. Hallelujah. See, today we will be reflecting on an area of compromise in the body of Christ which the Lord wants us to repent of. For that to have spoken this way, it's obvious that he's aware of some certain things that is going on in the body of Christ. And of course, as an elder statesman, it needs to speak out. And I'm so glad, as I was studying over the night, to see the way Daddy, precept by precept, line by line, giving us some of the areas where the church can compromise or has compromised. And we need quickly to return back to God and repent. See, this has to do with partaking in other men's sin. That is, you know, that was trying to explain what is a compromise. It has to do with partaking in another man's sin, whether by supporting, celebrating, or turning a blind eye to their misdeed. Is it that we are supporting them technically, or we are celebrating them? Can you imagine those who are evil men who go to church, who give them seats in their front? We celebrate them. We support them. We have a soft spot for them. Or turning blind eyes if we don't even know what was going on. So the reason why the Redeemed Christian Church of God is perceived by some to be too rigid, to be rigid on certain matters, is because we are conscious of the possibility of being an accomplice to heresies. You know, that's what oftentimes I tell people, that it is not good word or good messages, good preaching, so to say, from the sugar-coated mouth of the people on the altar these days, that we can sink in. No, you need to sieve it. You need to sieve it. You know, I do tell people, I said, anytime I'm going for some program, I usually went there as if I'm going to eat the head of a fish. If you want to eat the head of a fish, you need to be very careful. You don't eat the head of a fish closing your eyes. Your eyes have to be open so that you can see. Anytime you want to dodge some bone, you want to dodge some stones so that you can quickly see it and remove the eyes. One can damage his teeth or her teeth. Hallelujah. So, we prefer to give God the benefit of doubt rather than take things for granted. After all, it is safer to be overly obedient than to fall prey to sin. I was sharing with some people in our church recently. I said, it does not matter who support, who preach in support or preach against tithing. I said, I will continue to tithe until I see Jesus in glory. Now, if I get to Jesus, and Jesus said, my son, you should have paid your tithe, but however, come inside, it's fine. I prefer it that way than for me to think I'm wise here. By the time I get there, it may be too late to cry when the head is already cut off. So there are things that normally, you know, people have begun to contend against them. They were asking questions about the potency of those words. But it is very good to give the benefit of doubt to God. So today's memory verse is strong food for thought for the body of Christ. Very strong food for thought for the body of Christ. Through it, we understand that God's wrath is revealed from heaven, not only against those who commit acts that he hates, but also against those who have pleasure in those that do them. This is very interesting, but powerful. This teaching looks so simple, but so powerful. Because if care is not taken, we begin to compromise little by little. Compromise, support. We may not support, openly, but somehow with our attitude, our action, our inactions, we support some of these things. Praise be the name of the Lord. So the Lord will have mercy. The Lord will have mercy in the name of Jesus. So some pastors will say, what is my business? If a man divorces his wife and marries another woman, can you imagine? And this is happening. And we know it. We know it. Even if you tell some people, no, we can't do that here. We are under authority. We are under control of God, of our Lord Jesus, of the Holy Spirit. And this word is this word God said by His Spirit. And this word Jesus said by the Spirit of the Lord. I said, no, no. And before you know it, they leave church A and move to church B. And church B will wed them. And they will see church A as a wicked church, or pastor A as a wicked pastor. Hallelujah. The Lord will help His church in the name of Jesus. It is their problem, not mine. However, such pastors are not just witnesses, but an accomplice to the joining of two spiritual incompatible partners through remarriage, thereby approving of those who have gone against the Lord's instruction. They have gone against the Lord's instruction. And in 1 Corinthians chapter 7, verse 10 to 11, 1 Corinthians 7, 10 to 11, Bible is so clear there. 1 Corinthians chapter 7, 10 to 11 says, now to the married I command, yet not I, but the Lord, a wife is not to depart, to divorce from her husband. But even if she does, depart, let her remain unmarried or be reconciled to her husband. And a husband is not to divorce his wife, and vice versa. So the scripture is so clear. The word of God is so clear about this matter. However, we see this happening every day, every day, every day around us. Amen. May you not be a partaker of sins you did not directly commit, in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. In 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 22, 1 Timothy chapter 5, verse 22, Bible advises us by the Spirit of the Lord that we should not lay hands on people hastily. We should not lay hands on people arbitrarily. We should try to keep ourselves pure. And that's that admonition from the Spirit of the Lord. Because the person in question, you may not even know where he or she is coming from. You may not even know what he or she has done. And by laying hands on him, by laying hands on her, some things that may be a way of connect, there may be connectivity in the realm of the Spirit. And one can become a partaker of whatever that person, has involved him. So in the past, we were taught that it was not enough to abstain from alcohol. We were also expected not to serve it to others to drink. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 15. Habakkuk chapter 2, verse 15 says, and let me read. It says, woe unto him that giveth his neighbor drink, that putteth thy bottle to him, and maketh him drunk also. Also, that thou mayest look on their nakedness. The world is becoming churchy, and the church is becoming worldly. Sometimes we went for a naming ceremony of a supposed brother and sister in the church. And then somehow, I excused myself to visit the bathroom. And what I saw was shocking. Was shocking. So the question then is, who is deceiving who? So we are not only not to abstain from alcohol, but we are also advised, we are also instructed by the scripture not to even serve alcohol to people. But some will say, but me, I don't drink. But they can buy for others. Don't be an accomplice. Don't be an accomplice. Please don't be an accomplice. This was how my old friends knew that a change had occurred in me after I gave my life to Christ. That he was trying to bring us back to the early days of his salvation. When he gave his life to Christ. After he gave his life to Christ. When I started serving them soft drinks instead of whiskey and champagne, they thought I had gone crazy. Wow. That is, they thought he has gone crazy. Because that was not expected of him. They were expecting him to serve them champagne and serve them whiskey as usual. But he began to serve them soft drinks. And people said, what is wrong with this man? So another area of compromise that make believer accomplice is sin. Accomplice to sin is when they allow fraud to be perpetrated under their noses, and do nothing about it. This is very interesting, like I said in the beginning. When we allow fraud to happen under our care, under our control, they become an accomplice. There is a Yoruba adage which says, the one who collects this stolen cruse of oil is as guilty as the one who actually stole it from the kitchen rack. This same principle applies to those who allow their homes to be used for immoral acts. That's another area where Christians compromise, where we become an accomplice. Though you don't do it, but you allow such under your roof. Although some young Christians will not fornicate, they allow their unbelieving friends bring their girlfriends to commit sexual immorality in their houses. In the sight of God, they are as guilty as those committing the act. The giver of a bribe, that's another area. The giver of a bribe is as guilty as the taker of it. Because if somebody will not take the bribe, nobody will offer it in the first place. Amen. If no one will engage in drug, nobody will offer it in the first place. For anything to sell, there must be a buyer. So the giver of a bribe is as guilty as the taker of it. Don't be an accomplice to corrupt practices. The Lord is watching you, and he is coming back soon. The Lord is watching. He's watching you and I. And he's coming back very, very soon. I mean, he's coming. He's drawing nigh. He's very, very close. And he's coming to reward every one of us according to what we have done. So, don't let us become an accomplice in another person's sin. Let's watch our life. Let's watch what we do. Let's watch what we allow, particularly under our care. And the Lord will help us in the name of Jesus. So we are supposed to sing hymn 12, hymn 5, I beg your pardon. We're supposed to sing hymn 5 that says, let others see Jesus in you. Let others see Jesus in you. When people see us outside, what is their impression? When they see us, do they see Christ formed in us? Or when they see us, they see pride. They see arrogancy. They see, wickedness. When they see us, when they see you, when they see me, what do they see in us? So the song says, let others see Jesus in you. Let others see Jesus in you. And we have a prayer point inspired by the Spirit of the Lord through our Father. And we're supposed to pray together now that says, Father, please give me boldness to resist being an accomplice of evildoers in Jesus' name. Father, please give me boldness to resist being an accomplice of evildoers In Jesus' name, Lord God Almighty, we bless your name for your word that you have sent to us once again. We ask that you will please give us boldness to resist being an accomplice of evildoers in the name of Jesus. My God, my Lord, my Redeemer, you will please give us the boldness, the courage, the enablement. To resist being an accomplice of evildoers. Lord, please, you will give us the boldness in the name of Jesus. You will give us the boldness in the name of Jesus. You will give us the grace and the courage to say no to evil, to say no to wickedness, to say no to ungodliness. Rekoncha kabru sitaya, rena konsente limbro hotoya, rekaku prosile kambaru sosia, rekakuru moseketelia. Lord, we bless your name. We give you all the glory. We give you all the praise. Thank you, Father. As many who are under the sound of my voice, grace to stand firm. Grace, oh God, the enablement to be bold in order to resist being an accomplice of evils, the Lord will release upon you. In the name of Father and the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Eternal Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Thank you for listening to us today. Till I come your way again, God bless you.
let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven, let it rain. Let it rain. Open the floodgates of heaven. Sing out, let it rain.